So Ugreen recently sent us this little thing. They call it a Bluetooth transmitter for your Nintendo Switch. And they are calling this the, I don't know why they are calling this Mario, by the way. As our videographer guy here said, it looks like a Pokeball, but no, there's also a Luigi version. I'm not sure if it's available in the market right now. But anyway, since we have both the Aptx LL transmitter and receiver, we are going to tell you how do you set all of these things up and use Aptx LL with any wired headphone, speaker, or earphone. So if you want to use Aptx LL, what you need is a transmitter and a receiver. Both of them need to be Aptx LL compatible. If you want to learn more about Aptx LL and audio delay, you can check out our video playlist at the top right corner there, because it's kind of extensive and the topic will go on for a very long time, and we just want to keep this video short. So we'll talk about the transmitter first, because this thing is kind of brilliantly designed. It's very simple and it's made to use with the Nintendo Switch. So you can see here there's an audio jack. Just slot it in and then turn it on, pair with whatever receiver that you have, and then it will work instantly. Easy to use, and it's also very, how do you say this? You can use it with whatever case that you have on your Switch as well. So right here, I just have a very standard clear case. It's all scratched up, but you get the idea. There's a hinge here, so if your case is thick, like the Skull & Co case, you can still fit it in, and this thing will just point outwards. But with this simplicity right here, you have kind of a trade-off, because this thing has a standalone battery inside and it charges using a USB Type-C port at the bottom here. At least it's using USB Type-C, right, and not mini USB or micro USB. And the receiver that we have here is also from Ugreen, that we have talked about in our previous video, actually in quite a lot of our videos, which you can check out at the top right corner there as well. It charges using a micro USB port. So if you want to use Aptx LL, you need to charge a total of 3 different devices. So you have the transmitter, receiver, and also this thing. But of course, if you check out our previous video, once again, there are a lot of these kind of products that we tried out in the past. The GuliKit Rock Plus Pro, that one is using a direct USB Type-C plug, so you can just plug into your phone, Nintendo Switch, even your PC, and it will work with that USB power, so there's no need to charge that device. And one more thing that I don't really like about this thing right here, the Ugreen one, is that it cannot fit inside the dock. So if you want to play on a big screen TV, what you need is to get another adapter. Ugreen also sells that, by the way. So you have to convert from a standard USB port into a 3.5mm headphone jack before using this transmitter and transmit to this receiver right here. It's kind of annoying, but at least there's a solution, right? So to use Aptx LL, you need to pair both of these together. So once it's paired, you can just plug in like this wired earphone and then it will work with Aptx LL. So one thing about Aptx LL, which once again you can check out our previous video there, the latency is really, really minimal. It's the best out there in terms of wireless audio, and whichever brand that tells me that their true wireless earbuds are meant for gaming, it's all bullcrap. Because yeah, whatever we tried, the audio latency is just way too high, especially with true wireless earbuds. And as of now, the only true wireless earbuds that I can see is maybe truly low latency is the new Vivo TWS Neo, I think that's the name. That thing is using the Aptx adaptive codec. So in terms of codec, there are quite a lot of variants. Just for Aptx alone, there's Aptx, the standard one, Aptx HD, Aptx LL, and now Aptx adaptive. Aptx adaptive is kind of combining both Aptx HD and LL together, low latency, so it will dynamically switch depending on your workload or whatever you're doing. So if you want to play games, then we'll change to Aptx LL. And if you want to watch movies or listen to music where you don't care about latency, then we'll change to Aptx HD. And the problem with that Vivo TWS Neo is of course the transmitter part. Because currently, I think only the Vivo VX50, yeah, Vivo VX50 Only the Vivo X50 currently is supporting aptX adaptive, and throughout our experience we did not find any smartphone that supports aptX LL by default, which is why you need this kind of transmitter, which actually this thing also fits into many other smartphones, by the way, not just the Nintendo Switch. So if your phone has a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, plug it in, and the best part about this is it doesn't get in the way while you're playing games. So if you want to use aptX LL or low latency with whatever wired earphone, headphone or speaker, just get a transmitter like this. They also have a few different variants in terms of transmitters, also made by Ugreen, and the receiver. If you have both aptX LL receiver and transmitter, then you can enjoy aptX LL. And this transmitter thing by itself, it is priced at about 84 ringgit. I can't really tell you the price exactly because it changes kind of back and forth. And the receiver will run you for about 53 ringgit-ish. They are also available in a few different flavors, so check out Ugreen's website, Lazada page or Shopee page to find what suits your needs, because yeah, Ugreen just has a bunch of different ones to suit whatever need you have. And that is how you use aptX LL with whatever audio device that you have. And we are not going to do the usual audio delay benchmark here because we've already done it, and the aptX LL that is with these two products here works very well, and I'm very pleased with it because I play PUBG with it and I didn't notice any delay at all, which is fantastic. And I also played Xenoblade, by the way. And you remember those circle ring thing that you need to time? Yeah, I can time that properly with aptX LL. So leave your comments down in the comment section below, and if you have any questions, do comment down below as well, and I will try to answer you whenever I can, and we'll see you in the next video.